Both of them have different agendas. Both of them have pointless goals. Number one, they both want to go to SummerSlam and take away The Rock's WWF title.
No doubt about it. That's exactly right. And it could happen on pay-per-view Sunday.
Number two, they both want to win the hand, win the heart of the biggest piece of $2 rancid slut meat The Rock has ever seen.
God. Obviously referring to Mrs. Helmsley, I suspect.
So the fact of the matter is this, is that The Rock isn't thinking about SummerSlam this Sunday. The Rock is thinking about payback, and he's thinking about it tonight.
Tonight, right here, live.
Rock, I know exactly how you feel, because after all, once upon a time, I used to be a WWF champion myself.
And a great one.
I'm afraid I'm going to have to make an unpopular move. I'm going to give you the night off.
Tonight? Well, that's obviously a very unpopular move by our commissioner, giving The Rock the night off, maybe for his own good. And now we're being joined by the King of the Ring, Kurt Angle, a man that could be the next WWF champion, and his friend, Shane McMahon, who will challenge Steve Blackman tonight for the hardcore title.
Rock, I know you're upset, but see it from my perspective. Last week, when Commissioner Mick Foley was trying to split me and the McMahon-Helmsley family apart, what he was really doing was testing my integrity. Mick, you were trying to get me to turn my back on my friends and abandon them, and it almost worked. Almost. But I did come back for Rock and Triple H's match. And Rock, as you may recall, I bashed you over the head with a steel chair, allowing Triple H to get the win. And by doing that, by bashing you over the head with a steel chair, I proved I am a man of integrity. It's true.
How do you figure that?
It's true. I picked loyalty over selfishness. And Rock, even though you lost a match, I gained a friend. And I'd like to bring him out here right now. Hunter.
And now apparently we're going to be joined by another man that wants the WWF title in the very worst way, the game, along with his wife, the WWF Women's Champion. Triple H and Stephanie McMahon-Helmsley have joined their friend, Kurt Angle. And certainly Shane McMahon, Stephanie's brother.
You know, Thursday night, Kurt, you did show me a lot of integrity. And I've got to admit, it made me quite proud of you. You stood by my side.
The sold-out crowd getting their disapproval.
You see, the fact of the matter is, nothing will endear me to a person. Nothing will make somebody my friend faster than watching them wrap a steel chair upside The Rock's head. It's true. It's true. You know, Rock, you seem very upset tonight, and I can't blame you. I mean, after all, I beat you Thursday night in the center of that very ring. Now, since I seem to have my family problems behind me, I can get back to what I do best, and that is beating your ass. that upset and you feel like putting that title on the line tonight, then Rock, I would be more than happy to come down to that ring and kick your ass right in front of all these Cajun pieces of crap and once again become the World Wrestling Federation champion.
Tonight, so that the game's Tony the Rock.
Well, the Rock says,
Wait, Rock. Let me clear this up. Triple H, it's unfortunate that your ears aren't as big as your nose. Or else you would have heard that I gave The Rock the night off. And besides, you and Kurt are such good buddies. You're a well-oiled unit. You're like a team. You're close friends. So what I thought I'd do tonight is I would pit you against two other good friends, the Acolytes.
Oh, the Acolytes, the two biggest, nastiest son of a guns.
And listen, we've got, if it's championship matches you want, we've got two championship matches tonight. The first one pitting the hardcore champion, Steve Blackman, against you, Shane O'Mac.
Shane McMahon didn't want this matchup with Blackman. He's got it.
Commissioner Foley, I didn't think you were serious about that.
Oh, indeed I was serious. As serious as a Blackman family portrait. But you see, Shane, the good news is, if you survive the hardcore championship match, then you get to stand ringside and root on your little sister as she puts her women's WWF championship on the line right here in Lafayette, Louisiana. And Steph.
Mick, that is just fine with me. Because when it's all said and done,
Stephanie and Lita tonight.
After I pin Lita for the third time in the center of the ring, 1, 2, 3, I am confident that the referee will raise my hand in victory.
Steph, you bring up an excellent point, and that is, I can tell with your intestinal fortitude that this match tonight with Lita is going to be a Pier 6 brawl. It's going to be Katie bar the door. As JR might say, it's going to be a slobber knocker.
Maybe so.
And as commissioner of the World Wrestling Federation, I realize this match could get way out of hand. So what I'm going to need to do is appoint a special referee, somebody who can maintain law and order, somebody who's going to call that match right down the line, which means it's absolutely, positively got to be an individual who harbors no ill will whatsoever towards the McMahon-Helmsley family. Somebody like The Rock.
Oh my God, The Rock! The Rock! You can't be serious!
Hey, I'm sure you're gonna put on a hell of a show. I'm gonna sit back, watch it, and I'm gonna have a nice day!